Well, a bit of a wild and violent end to that video. I don't know about the rest of you, but maybe we need to call for an embargo of the Science Center of Iowa. At any rate, we actually do love you, Chris. You've been a terrific curriculum chair and an indispensable part of this program. And our sincere thanks go out to you and all the wonderful volunteers who have made this program such a success. To the Board of Governors, the Board of Ambassadors, the Class Project Committee, the Alumni Committee, you guys are the best. And of course, a special thanks to our Executive Director, Amy Jennings, and her assistant, Kelly Royal. Amy, it's your vision and leadership that has built GDMLI into a major asset for our community. And because of you, our best years lie ahead of us. Thank you for that. And finally, we certainly owe a debt of gratitude to all of our sponsors. You are enabling a program that is truly improving our community and changing lives. Thank you. So 9 months, where did all that time go? You know, when I first began seriously planning my remarks for today, my initial thought was that I needed to touch upon some of the highlights of the last 9 months and then wrap it up with some encouragement of the importance of giving back to the community in whatever time we have left. But my thoughts were interrupted by my wife shouting, "Kyle, it's 8:30, don't you need to shave and get over to Vets Auditorium for that graduation class?" So you may not get a whole lot of reflection from me today, but I do have a few things that I'd like to unpack, some observations that I'd like to share with you over the next 45 minutes or so. Now, although we literally rode on a bus on only two occasions, for some reason, when I reflect back on the last 9 months, it seems to me one long magical mystery tour by bus. Because consider this, we sit back in our seats, we gaze out the windows as this amazing tableau of people, places, organizations, and ideas go floating past our window. How better to be served than through a process like that? And early on, we cruised through the history of Des Moines. We rode past the monuments and the gravestones of our early citizens. We rode past that creepy cave-like building where they kept the bodies on ice during hot summer days. And occasionally, we were joined on the bus by fascinating people who illuminated the passing landscape with their insights and wisdom. Steve Chapman stepped aboard, and he shared memories of a community built by the altruism and steely tenacity of just a handful of citizens. He reminded us of a very unique attribute of our city. Any idiot can pick up the phone and get a meeting with one of our community leaders, regardless of their stature. And of course, that's a great comfort to all of us. And simply put, there's power in that kind of access. Our magic bus took us to places we might never have experienced apart from this program. We cruised through the historic buildings at Des Moines Waterworks Park, and we moved along their terrazzo floors between glazed brick walls. Gorgeous buildings where truly pride in workmanship showed through in everything that they did. And that pride was exceeded perhaps only by the staff working there. More wonderful adventures awaited us. We cruised through the inner workings of the Des Moines International Airport, setting off alarms wherever we passed. And we answered the age-old question, why is it called the Des Moines International Airport when there are no commercial flights to foreign destinations? Well, here's our answer. Corporate flights occasionally return directly from other countries. And when they do, the airport must maintain a customs desk to clear those passengers and their cargo. Think of a group from Pioneer arriving from South America with a bag of seeds. In my opinion, solving this airport name mystery alone made these 9 months worthwhile. Now, lessons in effective leadership were our constant touchstones during our journey. We grew as leaders, and what we saw around us made us proud and confident in our shared future together. We were grateful to live in a thriving and ascendant city, and truly our community has come far, and our best years lie ahead. But during our magical bus ride, some of the most enduring images came from a glimpse of another Des Moines, a Des Moines populated by individuals who will never step foot in this auditorium, who won't visit the fine restaurants we all enjoy, and who may never know the excitement of rushing off to college, or even the joy of finding a rewarding job. On Urban Core Day, we traveled the halls of Hyatt Middle School, a school with a dedicated staff and inspired leadership, and where 98% of the students qualify for a free or reduced lunch. After a tour and meetings, we boarded our bus for a ride through economically depressed neighborhoods. Neighborhoods with high unemployment and incarceration rates, lagging health indicators, and higher than usual crime. And these are the harsh realities, of course, faced by nearly every community of our size. We stopped at the Levitt Boys and Girls Club, where we heard from the CEO, who shared a story. One afternoon, she caught a student stuffing his pockets with cupcakes. When she asked him why, he explained that he hadn't eaten all weekend. He had been sleeping in his car with his mother, and they had no food for 3 days. Returning to Hyatt Middle School and feeling a little gut shot, we all walked through a lunchroom filled with shy but curious kids. Mostly they were African American and other minority ethnic groups. And afterward, I sat down with my friend, Kwesi Yeboah. And Kwesi shared with me that as we walked through that lunchroom, he could feel the eyes of those kids gazing at him with astonishment and with hope. You see, in our class of 50 developing community leaders, Kwesi is our only African American. Now, I thank God we had Kwesi, but I pray that in the future, those little kids will look up at the Greater Des Moines Leadership Group and see more people who look like them. So that's on us, alumni. Let's recruit, let's nominate. If the greatness of a city can be judged by how it treats its weakest members, and I believe that it can, then we all have work to do. Greater Des Moines has hundreds of dedicated professionals working tirelessly to improve the lives of our struggling citizens. But the problem is enormous. And frankly, now that we've seen these things firsthand, I feel that we are, in a very real sense, accountable. As Edward Abbey wrote, "Sentiment without action is the ruin of the soul." The good news is that many of our project teams will continue to support their nonprofits in the months and years ahead. My team, working with Joppa Homeless Outreach, has far exceeded the scope of our original plan. Today is graduation day, but our work has only begun. A fire has been lit in 50 developing leaders, and now we are equipped to give back to our community in ways that we never imagined before. We boarded this magic bus 9 months ago as strangers, but we disembark today as good friends. Friends with renewed vision and strengthened civic purpose. May these lessons guide us all as we leave purposeful and generous lives. Thank you.